Great here. Welcome back to Factorio. I just realized that day had started up. I wanted to take a look at the water, see how low they got. And they're right around 2K, which, well, I mean, the engines are off, so obviously they've gotten some water from the boilers. And we're finally done with this iron deposit here. In fact, we no longer need this merge point. There we go. So that is actually kind of scary, because let's look at the middle here. 654 in this particular tile. We're looking at another 24,000K. Yeah. I am definitely going to have to start thinking about going outside the base to get more iron. And let's take a look up here. I just saw another attack happen. Yeah, so there's 16 there, 15 there. Let's take a look at the ammo in here. Yeah, they're getting used. 6 of 10, 5 of 10 on that one. That is no longer being used. Let's look at this gun. I can't look at it, but yeah, okay, so yeah, this is definitely helping on the defenses up here. Okay. Let's get some more of this wall into... Oh, I just realized that I can see what it's deconstructing right next to the deconstruction planner. Herp-de-derp. Okay, and this wall here. Good. The reason I'm doing that is it takes a while for my wall resources to build up, so might as well recycle those whenever I can. Okay, so yeah, I'm not getting any attacks over here, so I don't need to put any guns over there. Let's see, where is it? There it is. And... just a few more solar panels, since I'm over here. And it doesn't take much to put down the blueprints. There. That's good enough for now. Oh, right. Four objects are missing materials. Yeah, they're on their way out. Had to remember. Flight time. So what do we want to do today? I think I need a lot of stone brick, is what I think. Do I have any stone brick in... no. Here's my stone brick. So let's take... ...300. We can get rid of all of this junk, please. Let's see. Available logistics robots, 6. This is exactly why I want more logistics robots, so they can take away my junk. Okay, so do I want to try to replace my iron with stone furnaces with electric furnaces? I mean, I just barely got power back under control. Let's actually start off with cleaning up the steel area first. So, first things first, I actually need more steel. And how many of these do I have here? Oh, they're going too slow because I think I just ran out of the logistics range and they ran out of power. Yeah. Whoops. Sorry, little buddies. Okay, so I want 8. Yeah, let's just make the whole 10 while we're thinking about it. Let's get this just out of the way completely. Definitely don't need any of this. And do I want to actually move? Because my steel production's been fine so far. No, I'm going to keep it over here because I want to make sure that I have room to expand. There it is. So, it's just a tad bigger, though. So, let's chop this line. Let's get rid of all of this. That way, I can place it and then worry about running the iron over again later. Are we out of power? Why is this 20 megawatts? I need more engines, that's what it is. You know, now that I've got the steel moved, I can put more engines in here. In fact, where is it? Yeah, I do have 10 more. Okay, so I was putting, what, 3? Let's actually put in... And we need to hook these into the power grid. So, oops, that is definitely not what I wanted. Good one. Okay, and my other engines, where are they? There we go. Nope, I need to drop this first. And more engines. Ow. Please don't trap me in. There we go. Okay, so... steel line is... where can I put this? Because I want to keep extending my engines out. I definitely need the more power. So... I don't need this coal here anymore. Don't need that coal. Don't need that splitter, in fact. Okay. So, with all of that out of the way, No, because I want the engines to come here, which means I definitely want to change up this. Yeah, let's just completely get rid of this for the time being. There we go. Let's get rid of this splitter. Get rid of the copper all the way across. And let's worry about the copper down to right there. Worker cargo size, excellent. Now let's get worker... not 3, because that's 450. I want speed. There we go. That's what I wanted initially. Okay. So now they can all carry a heck of a lot more, which means they can slurp all of this up a lot more efficiently. Excellent. Okay. So, we want to get... our copper over to here. I wish I had mined out all of this. I can move the iron smelting up a bit. But I'm going to leave the iron smelting where it is right now. And in fact, while I'm thinking about it, let's get another 10 engines to extend this out. Okay. You know what? I'm not going to do anything with this iron. We're just going to consider this legacy. If I do anything with iron at all, I'm going to do a brand new run. So what I can do now is let's rotate this over and let's go to right here. Okay. And let us change this up. We need okay, so iron, or not iron, but copper. This needs to be rotated. Copper is flowing once again. And in fact, no, not yet. Yeah, the copper's still been good on the single line of yellow, so we'll deal with that. But actually, I have basically two lines merging into one here. Oh, I screwed up the rotation. No, I don't want to make gears. Do not want to make gears. And I can get rid of all of this coal. Yeah, a little queen up here. I don't need the steel furnaces. Yeah, this looks good for now. Nope, I don't need the small orchard poles. Let's get that out of there. Okay. So from here, did I get more gear wheels? Yes, I did. Nope. God, it's so dark in here. I never put lights in my iron smelting area? Really? Wrong direction. There we go. I can make four of those at a time. I just want to get red all the way over to the first splitter. Why you do this to me? No, not a big power pole. Small pole. Small pole there will work. That was weird. Okay. Almost done. And now let's make all of these reds. There we go. Perfect. And in fact, I'm going to do the same thing up here. Let's get it red up to the first, and then we will replace all of these like so. Okay. You know what? Now that I know that this is legacy and I'm eventually going to get rid of this, yeah, let's actually just put our centralized storage right here. There. Just cover up those two sides of the of the RoboPort. So, yeah, this will be the centralized storage. Each RoboPort will have one chest for local storage for whatever gets shuffled out that direction. But eventually, you know, if those fill up, things will migrate out into here. Yeah, this is full. And on that note, since I have so many logistics bots and they're not being used entirely right now, let's actually use this chest. I rarely use these. This is an active provider chest. Anything that goes into this chest will be emptied. And in theory, they should... Why are you going that way? Okay, first things first. Grab, well, no, here, grab that. I've got to seed coal in each of these, is what I need to do. No. There we go. Okay. So, whatever chest they're... Where are they... Okay, so see how this one is now actually coming down here because it's closer? Now, these logistics... Well, they're going back. Where are you taking all of this coal? This is probably not the best idea I've ever had. Because the coal is going out into the middle of Timbuktu. Yeah, it is. Well, eventually it'll fill up. I don't care. I really don't. I just, I want to get that... The idea here is this chest is going to be pulling coal off of the line and moving it over to the other area. I want to basically get all of this out of here. And in fact, let's make this a fast... inserter. Because once this gets drained, the logistics bots will... It won't take many of them to keep that empty. Okay. Steel production. Engines is what I should be doing next. And why did I make an extra 10 again? That's just stupid of me. There we go. So, yeah, let's get these out of my inventory for now. I'll place them down later. There we go. Okay, so now we're up to 30 steam engines. Let's take a look at... And it's becoming night, so let's take a look at our power. So, we're using a total of about 20... Peaking up to about 24, it looks like. There was a peak to 27. So, yeah, these steam engines are helping. Steel production. Where do I want to go with steel production? I could try to cram it in here somewhere. Eventually these engines are going to... I think this is the extent I'm going to have on these engines. And in fact, what I'm going to do is I'm going to put a cap of one more water tank at the end of each of these. But they're going to be directly connected to the steam engines. To denote, I'm not going any further on these steam engines. If I have to, I'll build another boiler line to run more engines off of. Yeah, there we go. In fact, what I should do is make a ton more of these. What I should do is automate it. Hey, I haven't said that yet this episode. There we go. Yeah, there's the, they're bringing it over here and dropping it into these chests. See? If I highlight a chest, you can see what's coming to that chest. With the green outline. Okay. So, if I remember correctly, these lamps take iron sticks and green circuits and iron plate. Do I have any place that has iron plate and green circuits sitting next to it? Why, yes, yes I do. It's right here. Amazing how that works. But cramming the sticks in here would be annoying, to say the least. In fact, you know what I'm going to do? Okay, to get these started... What do I have? Oh, because I have 50 down there. Okay, so let's get these into the logistics network so they can be used elsewhere. And then what I'm going to do is... What was I going to do? Right. Okay, this is one of those things that's very little used, and I don't feel like running cabling everywhere. I just don't want to do it. I really don't. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take two assembly machines. Like so. This one... You make iron sticks, and you're going to feed directly into this one, who is going to... No, you're not going to feed into this one. You're going to feed into a requester chest. Huh, I didn't need that anymore. Good deal. Who's then going to feed into here? Who's going to go out into a passive provider chest? That is going to be limited to two stacks. And you, sir, are going to make lamps. You are going to request electric circuits. You're going to request a grand total of 25 of them. There we go. Yeah, I could try to squirrel this over and do goofy things, but really, I can't be bothered anymore. And I use these so infrequently that the amount of logistics bots that are going to need to service this is going to be minuscule. It really is. So, who cares? I certainly don't. Is everything powered up in here again? Looks like it. But if I get rid of these, I can make do with one. Good, good, good. Get these out of the way. Okay, so now I'm making lights. So whenever I plop down I'll still keep 50 on me, but now whenever I plop down a blueprint that requires those, I'm not going to have to make more by hand. We're slowly getting there. Anyway, I'm going to put a cut in here. Looks like a good stopping point. I hope you enjoyed the video so far, and the series, in fact. Have fun!